So we know that early intervention is associated with better outcomes in autistic development. We know that early social skills development in particular is associated with better social and academic performance throughout the academic years. But the problem is that early identification and early diagnosis is hard. Kids usually get their diagnosis when they're 3, maybe 4 years of age, often older than that. Some of our diagnostic tools aren't really reliable before 2 years of age. But it's helpful not only in terms of identifying children for intervention, but it's helpful for parents and kids who have access to information, services, and communities that are available to them once they have their diagnosis. In my lab, we've been using early social orienting in the first year of life to see if we can predict which kids might be developing with autism. So we invite kids into our lab as early as 3 months of age. Infants are coming into our lab. We recruit two different groups. The high-risk group is kids who have a sibling with autism. We know that autism is heritable, so we're taking this opportunity to watch autism develop. We've got a control group, which is our low-risk group, those kids who don't have any autism in the family. So these three-month-olds, infants in their first year of life, come into our lab, and we use eye-tracking technology to see if they're interested in social information. We measure their social orienting. So for example, we know that typical kids would rather look at direct eye gaze compared to averted eye gaze. So we use the eye tracker to see what these infants prefer. We show them a display with balls moving around on a computer screen. And in one side of the screen, they're chasing each other. On the other side of the screen, they're moving independently. And we, again, measure what's their social preference. What's their preference for this interactive social chasing behavior? Later, we give them, when they're older, we give them autistic diagnostic assessments so that we can see if this early social orienting is associated with later autistic development. The kids in our group who later have an autistic diagnosis, an ASD diagnosis, are less interested in looking at the chase scene compared to either of our other two comparison groups. They're less interested in looking at direct eye gaze. They have a weaker preference for the direct eye gaze compared to the other two groups. So this is consistent with the idea that early social orienting is important, and a lack of early social orienting might give us a clue that a kid might be developing with autism. So this is a longitudinal study, and we don't know at the end of the day what we're going to conclude, but we're hoping that we'll be able to develop some way to tell which kids we want to watch to see if they might benefit from early social intervention. Thank you.